Welcome students to class 8. Today we'll continue with our next chapter. The name of the chapter is The Brook. Before starting the chapter, we must know about the poet. So, Alfred Lord Tennyson, he was a British poet and he wrote The Brook in 1886. Just 6 years before his death. The poem is a ballad in which the speaker, the brook or stream itself, undertakes a long and winding journey across the countryside to join up with a large river. So, and another introduction is also given in your book that he was an English poet of the Victorian period and the poet literate from 1850 until his death. He used a wide range of subjects ranging from medieval legends to classical myths and from domestic situations to observations of nature as a source material for his poetry. Tennyson excelled in the use of the musical qualities of words to emphasize his rhythms and meanings and remained one of the most popular poets of the English language. So students, let's continue with our poem. First I will read the poem, then will explain you. I come from haunts of court and hern, I made a sudden chalet and sparkle out among the fern to bicker down a valley. So what is the meaning of this stanza? The brooks start from those places which are often visited by the court and hern. The brook emerges suddenly in this hilly area. It moves through the ferns and sparkles when the sunshine reflects the crystals. The crystal clear water. And when the brook moves, it creates a lots of noise. Okay, this is the explanation of the first four lines. The next second stanza. By 30 hills I hurry down or slip down the ridges. By 20 thorps, a little town and half a hundred bridges. So what is the meaning of this stanza? It is an account of the brooks flowing through different areas. The poet has created wonderful imaginations when he read the brook flowing by 30 hills, slipping between ridges and 20 villages and about going through the little town and 50 bridges. So he is creating a wonderful imagination how brook is flowing down. Then next, till last by Phillips Farm I flow to join the brimming river. For man may come and man may go, but I go on forever. So what is the meaning of this stanza? The poet here tells us about the merging point of the brook. The brook join an overflowing river here, which is Phillips Farm, is symbolized as a landmark of the ending journey of the brook. So what is the landmark of ending of the brook? That is Phillips Farm. Last two lines are the refrain bearing the main theme of the poem. What is the main theme? The brook is ever flowing. It is eternal without ceasing. Whereas the men are not forever. We shall not live forever. We are subject to decay, decline and death. They are saying, it is explaining about that brook is eternal. The next para, I chatter over stony ways in little sharps and trebles. I bubble into eddying ways. I babble on the pebbles. So what is the meaning of this stanza? The brook goes on the stony path, creating chattering sounds. It makes sharp, high-pitched sound when the brook clashes on the side banks of the land. It makes bubbles when it falls from height on the spherical movement. So when it is falling from the height in a spiral movements, so it is creating a bubbles. Okay, when it moves on the pebbles, it creates soft, pleasing sounds. The next, with many a curve, my bank I freed by many a field and fellow. एंड मैनी अ फेरी फॉर लैंड सेट विथ विलो वेड एंड मेलो. सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस स्टैंजा, वॉट इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन इज गिवन इन दिस, दैट द ब्रूक मूव्स ऑन टॉकिंग मैनी कर्व्स. द ब्रूक इज द ब्रूक्स मूव्स ऑन टेकिंग मैनी कर्व्स एंड क्रिएट रफ एंड अनप्लीजेंट साउंड्स ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द ब्रूक. And the brook moves through many fields and uncultivated lands. And brook also go through the foreland. That means, what is the meaning of foreland? The land just before the merging point. That is the foreland. The poet describes the land to be fairyland. It is with flowers and beautiful plants like willow and mallow. It looks so. The next, I chatter. Catter as I flow to join the brimming river, for man may come and man may go, but I go on forever. So the brook creates various sounds before merging its destinations. Okay, the two last two lines are again explaining about the theme of the chapter, that is eternal state of the brook and its activity, and the immortal state of and the man is not forever, that we are explaining in this, the poet is explaining in this two lines. The next, I win about and in and out with here a blossom sailing, and here and there a lusty throat, and here and there a grailing. So what is the meaning of this stanza? The brook on its way had lots of ups and downs and in its winding movements, but it often falls from heights and go in deep water and come out to continue to flow. That is the meaning. Okay, the brook carries blossom on its way. Along with the brook there go a lot of fishes like lusty throat and grailing. That is the meaning of this stanza. So the next is, and here and there a foamy flake upon me as I travel, with many a silver water break above the golden gravel. So when the brook moves, the waves clash with each other and create bubbles, and those bubbles in brook make piece of foams, and the brook moves through different curves. In the eighth stanza, what they are saying, that when the brook moves, the waves clash with each other and create bubbles, and those bubbles in group make piece of foams, and as the brook moves through different curves and clashes create silvery water break, and this forms and silvery water breaks into visible on the surface of the water, and at the base of the brook they are golden colored stones. Next is, read the next paragraph, next stanza, that is, and draw them all along and flow to join the brimming river, for man may come and man may go, but I go on forever. That means the brook carries fishes, forms and flowers with it to join the brimming river. And then the refrain comes, what is that? The eternal state of the river to that of the transient one of humans. Okay, the next stanza, I steal by lawns and grassy plots, I slide by hazel covers, I move the sweet forget-me-nots that grow for happy lovers. So what is the meaning of that? The brook secretly moves through the grassy plots and lawns and move safely by the bushy hazel trees. The brook shakes and sweet forget-me-not flowers which grow for happy lovers, and also it moves the sweet forget-me-not flowers with it. The next, I slip, I slide, I gloom, I glance among my skimmy shallows, I make the netted sunbeam dance against my sandy shallow. That means the brook moves along many different movements like slipping, sliding, moving through darkness and so on. So, and there we found, what we find? We find shallow birds to skim on the surface of the water for food. and then the brook move, what is the waves, so the brook waves create a net like structure on which the sunshine sparkle, and it seems to us as if the sun beams are dancing. You can imagine it. It will look very beautiful. The next stanza, I mourn under moon and stars. In brambly wilderness, I linger by my shingly bars. I loiter round my creases. That means, at night, under the moon and stars, the brook goes on moving, creating murmuring sound through the nature land where thorny bushes grow. And the brook often lingers because of the stones on the way. And brook moves purposingly around the plants named creases. The next. And out again I curve and flow to join the brimming river. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. That means, after facing the obstacles, the brook again takes a curve and start flowing to join the brimming river. And again, to the last line, two lines are explaining about the eternal state of the brook and transient state of the humans.